Springdale is a co-educational, international day and boarding school.
We are a warm, welcoming, and safe place to learn.
Hi, I'm Miss Davis, and welcome to Springdale Preparatory's art class. Except we're not in the classroom, we're in my studio. Today we'll be learning about synesthesia and making art related to it. Synesthesia is when one of our five senses, which is located like right here in your brain, you know what it is, taste, smell, hear, touch, all of that. One of our five senses stimulates another sense. And to clarify that, it would be like people can taste letters. Okay, so I wrote the word color on here. Now when we read that, I can't taste it. But some people might be able to taste garlic or cotton candy or something like that. The other thing that synesthesia can do is maybe you smell something when you touch something. So if I'm touching my desk, I might get a whiff of something. Not garlic, I already used that example. Pasta, that has kind of a weird scent, but this is wood, it's bland, so you might smell something kind of bland too. The other thing that synesthesia can do when all these wires get crossed in your brain is when you might see color when you hear something. And synesthesia is a real thing, but it only takes place in like 4% of the population. Not all of us have that superpower, only a specific group do. But one artist that we will be looking at today is Melissa McCracken, and she has chromosynesthesia, which is when she hears something, she can see color. To her, the beat in the music might look like puffs of smoke. A soothing melody might look like a soft blend of color kind of moving through the air. If you would like to learn more about Melissa McCracken and her amazing superpower, you can see the video link posted with this video and watch her paint the song Superstition by Jimi Hendrix. It's a very cool video, so check it out. Okay, synesthesia relating to art first gained some traction with artists around the end of the 19th century. For instance, Paul Klee, who is a great artist that you may have heard about before, listened to Bach while he painted. Kandinsky, who was well known for painting to music also, listened to his friend and composer, Schoenberg. His paintings often showed sharp angles for sharp sounds and softer circles and waves of color for the calm tones he was hearing. If you really look at his paintings, you can almost imagine the type of music that he was listening to when he painted it. So there's another artist you can check out. Okay. So today we are going to tap into our own synesthesia, and I know that most of us do not have it at all, but that's okay because music can still inspire us to paint something or to draw something that we hear. All right, so the way that we're going to tap into that is I have picked out a piece of music. It's called Married Life by Michael Giacchino, who is an American composer. You may recognize the music. It's featured in the movie Up. I don't want you to get any preconceived notions about that music and what you might paint or draw. Don't think that you need to paint something related to the movie or look like the movie, okay? I just want you to really tap into the music and draw according to the beats and melodies. All right, to start, you're going to need a piece of paper and a pencil. If you have anything to color with at home, so colored pencils, markers, crayons, or even if you have paints or watercolors, grab those too. We're not gonna use those right away. For now, we're just going to use a paper and a piece of pencil. You can even use printer paper, but just know that if you paint it, it's not gonna hold the paint well, okay? So grab anything that you can use at home. All right, I have my paper. I have my trusty Georgia O'Keeffe pencil. I got this at the museum. It says, an empty space will fill up with something. That's exactly what we're gonna do. I'm going to start my music. Now to start, I already have in my head that sometimes happy sounding things might have more of a round shape to me. And then maybe a sharper tone or a more upsetting music type of music that you hear might have a sharper shape, like a triangle or square or something like that. So knowing already that this piece of music is a little bit happy, I am thinking I'm gonna have a lot of round shapes on my paper, okay? And I chose this happy music because of the hard week we're all having. I hope you like it. Here we go. Okay, to start, I'm thinking I hear this happy little melody that kind of goes up and down, and it reminds me of bubbles kind of floating to the sky. Okay, so I've got these circles. Some of them are started already because we're on like take 10. Okay, more circles. Some of them are overlapping because it's kind of what the music does for us, right? That one's getting really high, and then when I hear those higher noises too, I think smaller and more detailed things. Like right here in the music, we're hearing a higher pitched piano, I think. And I'm thinking that this might be a more smaller detailed object, and it kind of goes up and down. So that's what I'm gonna draw. Okay, here it's changing. And this to me is a little sad, which if you've seen the movie, yes, it is a little sad right here, but I'm gonna come down further on my drawing. It's almost turning into like a little landscape thing. And I might have some little sharper images here, and I hear the music building, so they might get bigger and bigger. Some maybe half circles, almost like they're dancing, going up higher and higher. I'm gonna put some triangles in, but I'm gonna keep them low because I don't really hear this very sharp thing. They're kind of lower and a little bit more mild. Want to think about when I'm listening to music is maybe what color it would be. So over here I'm thinking more greens, and when it started I'm thinking more yellows. And we're done. Almost. Okay, a little bit more. This part reminds me of like a swirl. And here it gets a little bit more delicate, so I'm doing really little dots. And these I'm going to turn almost into like a teardrop because it seems kind of sad again. Next, we are going to apply some color. Okay, I'm prepping my paper to paint on it. I'm going to use watercolor today because the big sheet of paper that I used for this demonstration was watercolor paper, and I have my watercolors here in my studio today, so that's what I'm gonna use. Okay, I have a couple different styles, but you can use any one. You can just use a simple one like that. So I remember all these bubbles at top. I thought that they were like really light and airy. And I can even re-listen to the music. If I can't remember what color they were, I can just listen to it as many times as I need to. But I think I'm going to do these up here, more of a yellow color. I'm getting my paper wet in that area first. And for starters, I'm just gonna use this yellow right here, which is a little bit compromised because it's looking more like a yellow green from everybody sticking their paintbrushes in it, but that's okay. All right, so for now, I'm just gonna paint a whole bunch of yellow ones and maybe I'll switch to a different color as I go down the line. And it looks like I also needed a smaller paintbrush here. That's more yellow right there. Okay, as I work, we'll check in periodically, and then in the end, you can see the end result. I hope yours is going to be beautiful, and make sure to share that with me when you're done, because I would love to see what you've done in this assignment, okay? Okay, this is the part of the song that kind of gets sad, and to me, I might be thinking more about some deeper purples and things like that, so I've come off of this cliff right here. Colors. And I start getting happy again. I got to do those little triangles. And to me, my favorite color is like an aqua blue. So these little triangles are gonna dance over this way in that color. Alright, so I'm at the point in the song where I had all this pretty swirly things come up, and the little high-pitched notes in the music is why I did the dots, and now it's coming down, so I have my little raindrops here, but I'm keeping it the same color because it kind of feels like that in the song, like everything's cohesive, so it can be happy and sad in the same color. Alright, so I've got my little tear raindrop things coming down, and all I have to do is clean out my pencil lines, and I am gonna put another raindrop here. I am pretty much done. Okay, I have finished the painting. All in all, it took me from drawing it to the end of painting it about 15 minutes. I replayed the song over just a couple times to make sure that I was getting the colors right, what I initially thought they would be, and the shapes and things like that. So I'm just cleaning it up now after watercolor. Take the tape away, clean up your pencil lines. And this is why I say keep the pencil lines light, because I kept them really light and they're still flashing through where I would not like them flashing through. And then the last thing I need to do is sign my work of art. And because the name of the song was Married Life, that's what I'm gonna call the painting. I hope you enjoyed it, and please, like I said before, send me what you made. I wanna see it.
Springdale is a co-educational, international day and boarding school. We are a warm, welcoming, and safe
place to learn.